vaccination, schistosomiasis. This will be the short. This can be the shortest talk ever to be presented. I.e., there is no current vaccine. In fact, do we have a? So, have you got a microphone as well?
Two more.
Yes. Yeah. So. So thank you for your attention, and we can move on to the next talk. I could also talk a little bit about, actually there is maybe something in place. There is maybe something that might be in place in the future. So, first of all, I don't know if anybody knows this young man on the up here. He's a compatriot of mine. In fact, he's a Southwest German. He studied in Tübingen, and he's Theodor Gebhardt, and that's where the name Gebhardt came from. Where was he working? Does anybody know? Because in Germany we don't have a lot of schistosomiasis, neither in the UK, of course.
Egypt, exactly.
So, in fact, he is buried in the German cemetery in Cairo, unfortunately next to a very infamous man called Does anybody know actually what schistosome means? So it was decided in 1864 to call it schistosomiasis, or rather than Hansia, the parasite. It means a split body. So the split body is because we have this fantastic situation of a perfect couple. So the male and female adult worm are living together, and that's why it was called the split body schistosome. So just to outline to you, there are five different parasites in humans been reported. The most recent one was the Pokemon
from Southeast
Asia. We know 250 million people are affected, and there are between 10 and 200,000, depending on the statistics, deaths per annum. So it has a very significant disease burden, and actually it is one of the neglected diseases, and we'll see why as well. It requires snails as an intermediate host. You have on the here the Biomphalaria snail, and on the other side the Lepidoptera snail. Both of these species occur in Saudi Arabia. For the younger people in the audience, you all have to learn life cycles. Clearly an important one, and it shows that we are the definitive host. The disease presentation is that it is causing a swimmer's itch. In a vast majority of patients who get exposed to the Sicaria, within about 12 hours it can start. Within about 4 to 8 weeks, usually, the Katayama fever can occur, which is an immune response and can be quite severe, but cannot be treated with any anti-parasitic agents. And in the chronic form, we mostly have liver and gut involvement from the Manzanilla form, or we have the genitourinary involvement from the hematobium form. It has a significant distribution, and as you can see, the is affected. And in fact, there's only one area in this eastern region of Saudi Arabia that is not affected. So most parts are underneath Mansanai and Hematobium endemically. This is due to the fact that there are three Bulimia species and one Biomphalaria species in Saudi Arabia. So what can be done? Whether you are in the sub-Saharan Africa or Middle Eastern region, or whether you're in the Southeast Asian region, has a slightly different approach to, but ultimately it's an integrated approach with four areas. The first one is the most important one, or one of the most important ones that we can do something, is about control of snails. Molluscicides are an important part. The second part is actually probably even more important, that's general health education. We call it the WASH type, which is safe water, sanitation, and hygiene. And we have areas, particularly in Sub-Saharan Africa, where we are, through simple methods of filtering of water, of creating safe water areas, that you can really reduce the worm burden quite significantly, and also eliminate areas where snails are prevalent. The third part, of course, is chemotherapy. Egypt again has become very famous in the 1950s because it had mass treatment of schistosomiasis through injectable agents. Unfortunately, the unwanted side effect of that was that hepatitis C was introduced to that population in Egypt, which had in certain age groups a prevalence of up to 50%. And so Egypt became, a few years ago, became the highest hepatitis C prevalent countries, but that's another story. Praziquantel was introduced, and it is a very good and well tolerated drug. Unfortunately, it only works against the adult worm. So it's a treatment of established schistosomiasis. But it's not a treatment of eradication of the disease or reducing the burden overall. Studies have been carried out to combine antimalarials, in particular artesunates, with praziquantel, and that has a better effect and actually may reduce some of the worm load overall. So what about vaccines? We have a vaccine available, unfortunately, for humans. This is a transmission blocking vaccine in buffaloes. And this vaccine has probably an importance in controlling the zoonotic transmission, and thus maybe controlling overall the environmental worm load and transmission of japonicum or intercalatum. But it's not a human vaccine. There is certainly proof of concept in studies in mice that an attenuated vaccine against Sicaria has a 90% response rate. That approach, however, is unacceptable to humans in terms of like safety profile. The other issue about the vaccine is because it's a neglected disease, because it is in lower and middle income countries predominantly, the vaccine companies are not keen to invest lots of money and then have to give away a vaccine very, very cheaply. So we really need ultimately a combined concerted effort from governmental and NGO type institutions to support the research in establishing a vaccine. Some of the concept vaccines have achieved a reduction in worm load, but only of around 40%. There have been some promising targets, and it's easy to identify. Schistosome genomics is really fascinating. It is has a lot of targets, and we know that there is certainly in hematobium the SH28 GST has been identified as a target and is probably the furthest developed. It's undergone phase one and phase two studies and is together with the Institute Pasteur is being tested in phase three. Some of the blocking type or transmission blocking agents in Schistosoma mansoni have shown some promise, but they are either still in concept stage or only in phase one. But ultimately, as I said, all these vaccines have to be cheap and affordable to be produced. There may be one way of trying to push that a bit further, because some of the vaccines have crossover with some of the other helminths. Hookworms, for instance, may also be covered with some of the targets. So just to summarize, the most established one is the Virvax, which has the it's targeted against Schistosoma hematobium, and it is, as you can see, predominantly by charities or institutions sponsored. Whereas the mansoni vaccines are still in a much earlier development phase. The SM14 is a Brazilian type target. So in summary, there are a number of targets, mostly in the for Schistosoma mansoni, but they are in very, very early stages. So to summarize my one slide talk that I gave about the non-existent, we have a big disease with a high burden of chronic illness in people. We have praziquantel as a good chemotherapeutic agent, but with a low eradicating function. We require an integrated approach of hygiene control and vector control and treatment, currently as the mainstay of treatment. And vaccines are not in any marketable or producible state at this moment in time. And I just leave you with a nice picture of a perfect couple. Thank you very much. Yes, it is true that it's very easy to spot. However, it's quite some of the targets identified by my friend Jenny, serving the mice models, they achieve 90% of antigenicity, and it's an IgG3 and an IgA spot that is elucidated in those. But it is about, I think, the fact that we have in the maximum we have about 10 different targets is pointing towards the fact that we haven't identified the correct one yet. You're absolutely right. But we don't know whether we want the target that produces the workload or we want a target that produces that works with other phases of the life cycle. That is not being identified. With regards to the utopian, it is the target that has been identified in it, and it is seen as producing a high antigen response. And I think if any model or any vaccine is going to come through, it will be probably the first individual. Eradicating